Good afternoon. My name is Zhenning Li from Beijing GNOME User Group. Our company is China Standard Software. It's the first time our company to sponsor the GUADEC conference. As you say, my English is not good, so please do me a favor. Don't ask me any complex question. I can't answer. All right. First of all, I will introduce our company, China Standard Software, short for CS2C. We are a very small issuer of Linux in China, but we have more than about 16 years experience based on the Linux operating system. In 1999, we issued the first Linux version in China. And after 2 years, we issued the first desktop based on the GNOME 1.4. After 2001, GNOME became their exclusive choice, both of the server and the desktop system. And now we have more than 2 million customers per year. And first of all, we follow the community, use GNOME tool based our distribution, our desktop system. But in 2011, our customer and the market make me do a choice. We give up GNOME 3 and back to GNOME Mate. The good news is in this year, we will back to GNOME 3. We often ask our customer why you don't like the GNOME 3. It have so cool interface, but our customer told us the interface is uncomfortable, and many of application is not material as GNOME 2, and most of GNOME shell, JavaScript and HTML5. Is running smoothly in the low-end PC. The last question is a bigger question. As you know, China is a developer country. Many of low-end PC is in our countryside. So our desktop must be comfortable with this. So at last, we found a way to service our customer and our government is customization. The first big question is what is the most important things of desktop environment? That means, what is our customer major focus? You know, there are more than 92% market share in China is Microsoft Windows. And in 2040, China government forbidden the Windows 8 in their work office. And they hope many of other operating system such as domestic Linux can be used in the work office. So, our official is older man. Many of them are over 40 years old. They spent 1 year to learn how to use Windows, but now they must be to study another operating system. So they want the new operating system looks like Windows and can run in some Windows application. Another example is Munich government. In 2003, Munich government planned replacing Windows with Linux, and they confirmed migration more than 100 applications from Windows to Linux. And The bad news at the last year, Munich government installed Windows. But now, in this year, the hot news is Munich government said they will not give up Linux yet. I don't know what happened, and I sent an email to Munich government, but they not reply for me. But I think Munich government and the Chinese government has a similar question. It's a critical application. This is Linux, the operating system of Munich. This is a Chinese government operating system. It looks like Windows so much. If many government want to use the desktop environment, it's not only redesigner the layout such as start menu or another, but also must be much details, include critical applications such as popular input maps and other office tools. So Chinese government has a plan to replacing Windows in about 20 years. In 1995, they used Windows to their work office, and now they replacing Windows-like operating system. In the future, at 2020, most of Chinese government office will be replacing their operating system to Linux. So that is what is the most important things of government. First is office. The office is not only LibreOffice, because many office must be can translation another data such as a document and a table with Microsoft Office. And another is browser. Many of Chinese government office automation system is based on the browser and the server architecture. So the browser must be supported this architecture. And another tools such as a safety application, and they want a more friendly user interface. This is our operating system. Now, as another country, our government, many of common application is running in the Windows, but such as web emulator can not support this application perfectly. So we must provide some virtual machine. We call the cloud desktop to run in Windows. And many of critical application can run in Windows based on the Linux. Certainly, we provide an emulator to run in Microsoft Office. Not only government, but also some special industry can use customized Linux desktop environment, such as older people. You know, China has more than 200 million older people. It's a very huge market. But many of them feel lonely because they are without children around them. So they want a community with computer and the internet, but how to train them to use computer? Such as my parents, they are over 70 years old, but I spent one day to training them to use Windows operating system, but they still cannot remember to click start menu and the browser application and double click. So that's our answer. we redesigned the desktop of GNOME environment, and we removed the start menu. Only some of big icons, such as the health and safety technology, video chat, and entertainment, browser picture. Old man don't need to any train. They can use the new computer directly. Another is a famous computer. We removed any unnecessary function and icons. Only icons about the list of the price list of coins and e-learning and entertainment. But if you want to GNOME, you can click this button. So we have some job. What is the feedback from market? The Dell and HP, they told the Wall Street Journal that more than 42% of PCs sold in China is ships new killing our desktop per year. That means every year more than 2 million of GNOME desktop are provided in Chinese users. So that is a very important thing in China ecosystem. There are three keywords, brand, customer, and ecosystem, both of desktop and server. China has a very special environment because open source software must support more architecture, not only Intel architecture. So this is a Chinese CPU process based on the MIPS platform. And another application must support two architecture, Intel x86 and MIPS Chinese architecture. This is our customer, General Office of the Statement, like Chinese White House. And this is another customer. So if you go to China, many of our customers use open source software. When you go to China with flight, you want to buy some ticket, many of electrical ticket system use our Linux. And Beijing, Shanghai, some of a bigger city like another country have a very big problem is a traffic jam. So many of traffic management center use Linux to administration the city traffic. And Beijing, Shanghai, some subway AFC means a ticket system use Linux. All of them is based on the GNOME. And this is beside a medical terminal and distance learning and banking system. All of them is customized GNOME system. So China has so huge open source market, and we have many of open source promotion union, such as Beijing GNOME User Group and Kaiyuan She. It's another big community created by Emily Chen. So it's okay. this guy is a spirit leader of China, and they said, if you work, Karl Heinrich Marx decided if you, anybody works for a common proposal, it make themselves to more noble and greatest. It's very be honored to hear and enjoy the new foundation. Your work is very great. Make more people to greater. Thank you.
So any other questions? Any questions?
Hello. First, thank you for the presentation. It was really good. Pretty interesting what you're doing. Have you, so you mentioned you work with the government. So government internally, they deployed your operating system, mm-hmm. right? Have you worked on any tools or can you talk about the challenges of deploying large
such as these tools, is 360. It's a very popular and safety tools in China, but it's only have Windows version. We community with the enterprise and the migration to Linux, and input medicine is similar from Windows to Linux. But this is very important to our government.
All right, thank you.
Any others? All right, I think that's all. Thanks.